الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام عليك يا صفوة الأنبياء والمرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن الكريم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. أياما معدودات، فمن كان منكم مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين، فمن تطوع خيرا فهو خير له، وأن تصوموا خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان، فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه، ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر، يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر، ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون. وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب، أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعاني، فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. صدق الله العظيم، وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم. وقال حبيبه المصطفى المجتبى صلى الله عليه وسلم: من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. وقد صدقت أنت يا سيدي يا سيدي يا سيدي، يا مكي يا مدني يا عربي يا قرشي يا هاشم، ويا سيدنا يا سيدنا يا سيدنا، يا حبيبنا يا طبيبنا، يا حبيب المصطفى المجتبى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. In these Quranic verses, Allah جل وعلا has commanded us, has ordered the Ummah of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم to observe صوم. The hukm of fasting was given to the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The ahkam of Ramadan and the ahkam of fasting are only found in the Quran, in one part of Quran, and that is in Surah Al-Baqarah. It is only these Quranic verses. So if you want to study the ahkam of fasting, the laws of fasting, the rulings of fasting, the wisdoms of fasting, the usul of fasting, the fiqh of fasting, everything is in these Quranic verses. These verses of the Quran that I've just recited in Surah Baqarah. And this begins with verse 183 to verse 187. All Ramadan and ahkam of fasting are from 183 to 187. Everything about fasting is in these Quranic verses. So if you want to study the ahkam of fasting in Al-Quran, it is in Surah Al-Baqarah from verse 183 to verse 187. Inshallah, we will be discussing the shan and nuzul of these Quranic verses also, and why Allah Jalla wa Ala selected Surah Al-Baqarah for the ahkam of Ramadan. Inshallah, we will be discussing that in detail. First thing that I will begin with is the hukm, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, O believers, kutiba alaykum as-siyam, fasting has been prescribed upon you, kama kutiba ala alladhina min qablikum, the way it was made an obligation, obligatory upon those who were before you. And then Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions the maqsad of fasting, the goal of fasting. Why is it that we fast? Why do we keep roza? Why do we observe fasting? What is the maqsad of it? What is the goal of it? Is it about remaining thirsty, hungry, controlling your desires, not to have a relationship, an intimate relationship with your spouse? Is it all about that? الله جل وعلا says لعلكم تتقون. The maqsad of fasting is taqwa. Is to attain taqwa. The word taqwa comes from al-wikaya, and al-wikaya means protection, to protect yourself. It is a state of consciousness, awareness of Allah Jalla wa'ala, to fear Allah Jalla wa'ala, to have the khawf of Allah Jalla wa'ala. And when you fear Allah Jalla wa'ala, and when you have true love of Allah Jalla wa'ala, you will protect yourself from everything that displeases Allah Jalla wa'ala. And it is interesting that even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he refers to as-sawm, he says as-siyamu junnatun, fasting is a shield. As-siyamu junnatun, fasting is a shield, and shield is used for protection, to protect yourself. And here in the Quran, Allah Jalla wa'ala says kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba 'ala alladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun, that fasting has been prescribed upon you the way it was prescribed upon those who were before you. And who are before us? Who has come before us? It is the Bani Israel. In Surah Baqarah, Allah Jalla wa Ala mentions Bani Israel. Before this verse 183, Allah Jalla wa Ala repeatedly reminds the Yahud about their lack of taqwa, that they did not have taqwa. Allah constantly mentions that. Ya Bani Israel, O Bani Israel. Remember, they observed fasting. They kept roses. Even the Yahud, the Nasara, the Hunud, before fasting became farz upon the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the month of Ramadan, the fasting of Ayyamul Bid was farz. Ayyamul Bid are the 13th, 14th, and 15th of every month, the 10th of Muharram. Now the ahkam are changing. The hukum is changing now. Allah Jalla wa'ala is addressing the Yahud that the purpose that Yahud were given a hukum, and that was of fasting. And the purpose of their fasting was also taqwa. It was to attain taqwa. Consciousness of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Awareness of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Fear of Allah Jalla wa'ala. Which the Sufiya, they translate the khawf of Allah Jalla wa'ala as the true love of Allah Jalla wa'ala. When you love someone, then you fear displeasing your beloved. That is also khawf, and that's taqwa. So Allah Jalla wa'ala repeatedly mentions, O Yahud, O Bani Israel, fasting was made farz upon you. But you did not have taqwa. You did not have taqwa. You did not have taqwa. And then when Allah Jalla wa'ala gives a hukm to the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions the same thing. That the previous nations, the hukm for them was to observe roza, to observe sawm. And the maqsad of their song was also taqwa. And then Allah Jalla wa'ala says, O believers, now fasting has been made farz upon you, the way it was made farz upon those before you. And the maqsad of fasting for you, it is the same as the previous nations. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you attain taqwa. It is the same, there is no difference. So do not make the same mistake as the Bani Israel. Do not make the same mistake. The mistake that they made. What was their mistake? They used to fast, even though it was different. It was for 3 days and 1 day. And then there are many other different ahkam. Because they would do iftar, and after iftar, if they were to fall asleep, then after that there was no suhoor. They would remain hungry till the next day's iftar time. And this was another confusion in the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which the next verses of the Quran, in which it is clarified. Now, with the Yahud, the issue with them was that when they heard the hukum for the Muslim has come from Allah Jalla wa'ala, and just before this, just before the hukum of fasting, Allah Jalla wa'ala gives the hukum of the changing of Qibla. The changing of Qibla. Allah Jalla wa'ala mentions, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَ